Meanwhile, the government's anti-communist task force insists schools, churches, and even charitable institutions are still being used by the New People's Army to gain new recruits. The task force held an online forum warning students about certain tactics supposedly being used by the CPP-NPA to lure new members. They say targets are usually students and members of the indigenous groups. The task force also reiterated their claims against the leftist groups in the country, linking them to the communist movement. The task force has been heavily criticized for supposed red tagging after it accused several personalities, including actresses, for supposedly engaging in communist activities, despite not having enough evidence. The Communist Party of the Philippines admits it breached international laws after the landmine blast by its armed wing, the New People's Army, that killed footballer Keith Absalon and his cousin. Information Officer Marco Balbuena says they will immediately provide full compensation for the families of the victims as part of what they say is their obligation under the Geneva Conventions. Balbuena adds that the CPP is assessing the tragedy to make sure it doesn't happen again and that members behind the incident are held accountable. In other news, a Filipino athlete and his cousin, who were killed by a landmine blast in Masbate province, are said to have been shot as well. The death certificate of footballer Keith Absalon and his cousin indicates they died from injuries suffered from the landmine explosion and from gunshot wounds. There was no mention of who may have shot the victims. Philippine National Police Chief Guillermo Elazar dares the Communist New People's Army to surrender who may be responsible for the killings. That's after the rebel group claimed responsibility for the incident. The Philippines and China mark 46 years of diplomatic ties, recently strained by the maritime dispute in the West Philippine Sea. But Philippine President Rodrigo Duterte says the country should still aim for a win-win cooperation with China. Details from Willard Cheng.
Amid the maritime disputes, the Philippines and China found a reason to celebrate the 46th anniversary of diplomatic relations, which also happens to be the 20th Filipino-Chinese Friendship Day. Chinese President Xi Jinping sent a letter to President Rodrigo Duterte wishing the country well. The Chinese leader adds he is ready to work with his Philippine counterpart in guiding the bilateral relations to achieve what he described as win-win results and mutual benefits. Xi noted that Philippine-China relations remained healthy and stable, which he said have brought tangible benefits to the two peoples. He noted how the Philippines and China helped each other overcome the COVID-19 pandemic. In his message during the virtual reception, hosted by the Filipino-Chinese Chambers of Commerce and Industry Incorporated, Duterte echoed the sentiment of his Chinese counterpart. In a separate letter, Chinese Foreign Minister and State Councilor Wang Yi told Philippine Foreign Affairs Secretary Teodoro Locsin Jr. he is ready to fully implement the important consensus between Xi and Duterte to fight the pandemic, deepen cooperation, and effectively manage differences. The letters came on the heels of a series of diplomatic protests filed by the Philippines over the illegal presence of Chinese vessels in Philippine waters. As of May 28, the Philippines has filed 99 protest notes against China, including the daily protests that the DFA vowed to file every day, as long as Chinese vessels remain in Julian Felipe Reef. On Monday, foreign ministers of ASEAN and China reaffirmed the need to maintain and promote a conducive environment for the negotiations for a code of conduct in the South China Sea. Wang and Locsin co-chaired the meeting in the Chinese city of Chongqing to mark the 30th anniversary of dialogue relations. The Philippines is currently the country coordinator for ASEAN-China relations. The foreign ministers also discussed upholding freedom of navigation in an overflight above the South China Sea, exercising self-restraint in the conduct of activities that would complicate or escalate disputes, and pursuing the peaceful resolution of disputes in accordance with universally recognized principles of international law. Willard Cheng, ABS-CBN News.